Yo, 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 CPA Strength here checking in once again. I am the strongest licensed CPA in the whole entire state of Florida. Yes, I am a little preoccupied with Hurricane Irma. I believe that's her name. Hopefully everything will be right. Everything will be okay. I'm filming this the day before. Friday, Hurricane Irma is supposed to hit, let's see, what is it? It's September 8th right now. Hurricane Irma is supposed to hit Friday, September 8th. Hurricane Irma is supposed to hit, September 9th to 10th. It's early in the morning Friday. It's supposed to hit, Saturday afternoon to Sunday afternoon, I believe, so I'm gonna hope for the best. Anyway, so yes, I am preoccupied with that, so wow. I already said who I am, what do? I teach the world basic accounting, building block by building block by building block by building block. And this happens to be the best playlist in the whole entire world right here. It's the best playlist. It's the best. It happens to be an accounting playlist, but it's the best playlist. It's biodegradable, make all your dreams come true, find you companionship. Just everything good in life is there, everything bad is not there, like my positive thinking. This is the DCA, the real spill. This will really help you. This is why I have how many subscribers you probably see I have right now. I know it's over 25,000 though. Anyways, yes, I was blessed to hit 25K a few days ago, just so much going on. Anyways, DC Adler, debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. This isn't really about the DC Adler or this journal entry. This happens to be, I think, this is number 11 on Widget Inc. So it's our own private little company. I really think once this, I think I'm going to do like 25 of these or 30 or something. I'm not sure how many Widget Inks I'm going to do. I really think after it's all said and done, I'm going to make a standalone playlist of Widget Ink. Well, you could do that right now if you wanted. And it's going to be a really good, like, series. Like, people are going to really like it. And I don't know. I think it's good. So what we're going to do, this is number 83 right here. What we're going to do in number 83 is it's accounts receivable. And yeah, we've done this before. We're gonna get paid off an accounts receivable. So we had an accounts receivable on the books, and now we're gonna get paid. So I put a Widget Incorporated, that's our business here, gets $10,000 from the vendor that owed us money. See, they're not gonna spell it out every time, oh, it's accounts receivable, but that's what I put, from the vendor that owes us money. Cause there's only one person, only one vendor that owes us money. So if someone owes us money, that would be an accounts receivable, right? That would be an asset. Someone owes us money. We got money coming into us. So that would be an asset. We'd look at our chart of accounts, our general ledger. Well, we'd see an accounts receivable in our general ledger. And our chart of accounts. And then we'd pop into that and then go over our a ledger and see that, yes, we had a certain vendor. We had a certain someone that owed us $10,000, so now we're getting paid from him. So we know what's going on. We look and see what's going on. You gotta be a little detective-ish. So for that, we're gonna have, let's see, get $10,000. So we're gonna follow the money. So we're getting, we're putting in our checking account. So a checking account is an asset account, and we're getting, so it's going up. So if an asset's going up, it's a debit. So checking account, 10,000, asset going up is our debit. What's our credit? What's our credit is, well, the vendor that owed us money, so that's the accounts receivable account. So it had a balance of 10,000, but then he doesn't owe us the money anymore. So the accounts receivable account is reducing. So that's why that's gonna be our credit, because it is an asset. Accounts receivable is our asset, but it is reducing, lessening, so that's why it's going to be our credit. And of course the amount is $10,000, and of course Of course, debits always equal credits. So $10,000 equal $10,000. Of course. And this happened at 11:30:15. Let's go to another board. Yo, that's looking good. So this is our chart of accounts and our general ledger board. So let's just get through this one because although this one's important, I like to move through this one fast because I don't think there's, I think you need to know the information here, but not get bogged down on it or anything. So what were the two accounts that we just used in our journal entry? Because we're doing our journal entry and then we're seeing what accounts it affects. So we just wrote our journal entry, we used the checking account and accounts receivable accounts, okay? Did we already have those in our chart of accounts? Yes, we did. We had an accounts receivable account and checking account because, of course, we had a checking account, right? Because we use that almost every time, right? Yeah. So we don't have to add anything to our chart of accounts, but in our chart of accounts, these are all accounts that we've used, all journal entries and accounts that we've used and we have general ledgers for. But for these two certain accounts, the checking account and accounts receivable, let's look at the general ledger. Let's go to the accounts receivable down here first. I hope you can see it. Yeah, I believe you can. But it ends up being zero because you had 8/31/15. See, that's when the person owed us money. So the accounts receivable account went up. And then 11/30/15, a couple months later, is when we got paid the money. The $10,000. So our accounts receivable has a balance of zero. But you know, it's still really nice to see what happened in this account. So you would leave it, you know, on your books and stuff. You know, your books, I guess. These are our books, I would suppose. Anyways, the checking account. Now look at the checking account on our ledger. This is what, our 11th month? I think we've used it every time, but 6, 7, 8. Two times we haven't used it. I think that was for an accounts receivable and accounts payable. See? And then, so you can, well, you gotta delve a little deeper in things, cause then you can see, you know, hey, we've, whoa, okay, 2 months, two journal entries, we didn't use the checking account. What did we use in place of that? We used an accounts payable and accounts receivable. One someone owed us and one we owed someone. So, anyways, this happened to be, what, we got $10,000 in our checking account. So now we have $12,000 in our checking account, and our accounts receivable is now zero. Yo, I believe you can see everything. Woo! Dang, your boy's getting kind of jacked though, right? Like, seriously, like on the reels though? Just saying, dawg, I'm just saying, your boy's getting kind of jacked, damn. Damn, I'm making some gains though. Third board, let's go. All right, income statement. Ooh, the income statement is for a period of time, and our period of time is from the beginning of the company, 01/01/15 to 11/30/15. Our journal entry, which was, dang, yo, that's 450. Yo, I don't even remember making a freaking alarm for that. My life is a mess right now. 4:50 a.m. I had an alarm go off. I don't even know why. Why did I have to wake up at 4:50 today? To film this video? But I woke up at 3 to film these videos. Jeez, let's go! Let's go! Alright, so our journal entry had accounts receivable and checking accounts. Those were both asset accounts as we specified before. So it did not mess our income statement. That did not change it. Mess it up, but it didn't change it at all. So the income statement is revenue minus expenses equals the net income, which our net income happens to be $4,000. The net income is a very big number because it's on the income statement and the balance sheet, the same number. It goes from the income statement over to the balance sheet in net incomes under the equity section. Assets equal liabilities plus equity, that's the balance sheet. Whereas the income statement is for a period of time, the balance sheet is just for one day. So, you know, we're in December sometime probably doing this November's journal entries or whatever. So we're kind of go back in time. But this is just for a certain day. Anyways, it has the income statement, the net income, what happened on the income statement right here. So it's a big thing, and you would always look at what day it is, because that's big, you know. Anyways, assets equal liabilities plus equity. The liabilities and equity did not change because we just messed with the assets. We reduced an asset, the accounts receivable, we reduced it so much it's not even on our balance sheet anymore. Alright, and we increased the checking account by $10,000 up to $12,000. So really, nothing changed. The total assets of $16,000 didn't change. What it equaled, liabilities and equities of $16,000, did not change. Our liabilities are, we have loan from shareholders, $7,000, accounts payable, $5,000, so $12,000 in liabilities. And our equity consists of $4,000 of net income, which is $16,000 of liabilities. Our assets are $16,000 of comprised of $12,000 in the checking account, which we just got $10,000 from the accounts receivable, and the truck of $4,000. I want to talk about the power of positivity. Seems like I'm very big on that, like with just being positive, because this is September, my month of positivity. I'm really trying to be glass half full, trying to be everything just very positive, 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 trying my hardest. And then it's only what, September 8th or 10th, like I got this big hurricane coming. I'm just trying to be positive and think of the best. A friend of mine that I don't see that much because I'm just so busy, he's so busy. I helped clean up his house for the hurricane coming, like his patio stuff, and put it in his garage. And I was thinking, like, you know, on the bright side, glass half full, that this is a chance for community to come together, possibly. Well, it's a chance for me to help my friend out and show him that, you know, like, I'm here for him and I care about him. And I don't know, like, everybody's worried about me, and I'm gonna be fine. I can just, like, feel it, like, I'm like, yeah, there's no way that I'm not gonna be fine, because, like, I'm loving making these videos too much. This feels like so perfect. Like, just me making these videos just feels too perfect, so I'm gonna be fine. But anyways, before I might have been thinking negatively about the hurricane, but now I'm thinking just, like, you know, bring the community together and everything like that. And all right, anyways, went long enough. Till next time, deuces.